Let's take a look at the atomic structure for aluminum, that's Al, on the periodic table. And we're going to use a Bohr diagram here called a Bohr model to visualize that atomic structure. So starting out, if we look at aluminum here, it has an atomic number of 13. What that means is the atomic number, that equals the number of protons. So we have 13 protons here in the nucleus of the aluminum atom. The number of protons when we have a neutral element, and all of the elements listed on the periodic table, they're listed as neutral. The number of protons equals the number of electrons. So we have 13 protons in the nucleus, and then we have 13 electrons around that nucleus in these different energy levels here. For aluminum, we have three energy levels. Let's take a look at the periodic table and see how these electrons are distributed around the nucleus. So we have 13 total electrons for aluminum here. We have in the first energy level, that's the first period, we have 1, 2, and we put those right here in this first energy level. After that energy level is full, so we go to the second energy level. That has 1, 2, then we keep going across here, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So the second energy level has 8 valence electrons. 2, 4, 6, 8. That's the second energy level. We've used 10. We have 3 more electrons for the aluminum atom. We go to the third period, the third energy level, 1, 2, 3, and this is aluminum right here on the periodic table. So we put those three in the highest energy level. That's the third energy level. These electrons in the highest energy level, they're important. They're called valence electrons, and they're involved in chemical bonding. If you need help figuring out the electron configuration for aluminum or the number of neutrons, there's a link at the end of this video. This is Dr. B with the Bohr diagram, also called the Bohr model, for the aluminum atom. Thanks for watching.